Okay, listen carefully. Isomerism. Okay, what is isomerism? Isomerism means, first the definition, let's listen carefully. Isomerism means you have to take two or more than two organic compounds. Two or more than two organic compounds, if you are taking that organic compound, the basic common criteria, what dear students, they having same molecular formula. Means what are the elements? For example, one organic compound, if you are observed that four carbon atoms, 10 hydrogen atoms are present, like that arrangements, different arrangements are present, then we are getting different types of organic compounds. But the both organic compounds having same molecular formula means the number of atoms, carbon atoms, hydrogen atoms, or whatever it may be, oxygen atoms or any other atoms are present, that the all atoms are similar. That is called a same molecular formula. If molecular formula is same, means automatically they have same molecular mass. So the organic compounds, two or more than two organic compounds which are having same molecular formula and same molecular mass, but they having the, what is the difference of their isomers? Their difference is they having different physical and chemical properties. Both physical properties as well as chemical properties, both are different. Such type of compounds are called as isomers. And the phenomena is known as isomerism. The phenomena is known as isomerism. Okay, understood ma? Definition. Later I will give you examples, types of isomers, isomerism, and based on that each type of isomerism I will give you examples, then we will get idea about this concept, isomerism concept. First definition for isomerism means, imagine that generally what type of compounds are called as isomers. In order to, the compounds belongs to isomers means, first the common criteria is they have same molecular formula. They have a same molecular formula is present, then the compounds are called isomers. That isomers are belongs to what type of isomers and everything we discuss step wise. Okay students, so the isomers, you don't imagine that the isomers having same molecular formula, that's why they have same physical and chemical properties. Here the physical and chemical properties are different because of bonding connectivity is different. The bonding connectivity of carbon atoms or arrangement of groups around the carbon atoms, that is different. That's why they having different physical and chemical properties are present. They having different physical and chemical properties are present. That's why we are discussing about that isomerism concept. Isomerism concept. Okay. Let's see, based on the bonding connectivity. Based on the bonding connectivity, isomerism. It means isomerism. It is two types. Isomerism is two types. Based on the bonding connectivity, bonding connectivity is different. Yes ma, that I am explaining everything, don't worry. Nischal, first listen. Isomerism, based on the bonding connectivity, isomerism is two types. The bonding connectivity is different. The bonding connectivity is different, those are called structural isomers. If the bonding connectivity is same, those are called stereoisomers. So
those are called stereoisomers.
Again, the structural isomers are different types of structural isomers are present.
Those are the first one is chain isomer. The second one is position. Positional isomer. The third one is functional isomer. The fourth one is metamerism. The fifth one is tautomerism. And the sixth one is ring chain isomerism. Like six types of structural isomers are present. So if the based on the bonding connectivity, isomerism is two types. If the bonding connectivity is different, those isomers are called structural isomers. If bonding connectivity is same, but the groups around the groups are present in different sites, the attached groups are the orientation of groups is different. The bonding connectivity is same, but orientation or position of groups are different. Those are called stereoisomers. Again, the stereoisomers are two types. Conformational isomer. Conformational isomerism means this is examples alkanes and cycloalkanes shows conformational isomerism. The second one is configurational isomerism. Conformational isomerism is a rotation about carbon and carbon single bonds. So the carbon and carbon single bonds are present in alkanes. So the alkane shows conformational isomerism. The second one is a configurational isomerism. Again, the configurational isomerism is two types: geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. Geometrical. Optical isomerism. Okay, students. Again, this geometrical isomerism is two types. Different types of geometrical isomerisms are cis and trans geometrical isomerism. The second one is EZ geometrical isomerism. The third one is syn and anti-geometrical isomerism. Okay, optical isomerism. Let's see about optical isomerism. The optical isomers are two types. One is enantiomers. The second one is diastereomers. It is two types. Enantiomers diastereomers. Enantiomers and diastereomers. So this is about flow chart, complete isomerism flow chart man. So after that, first we have to discuss about the structural isomerism. Later we have to discuss about the conformational isomerism. Later we need to discuss about the configurational isomerism, in which geometrical isomerism we need to discuss, as well as optical isomerism also we need to discuss. So this total isomerism concept compulsory one question guarantee for NEET and JEE and CET examination. Any competitive examination you have to take compulsory one question will comes.
isomerism means what, dear students? The isomerism means the organic compounds having same molecular formula. Organic compounds having a same molecular formula as well as same molecular mass, but they having a different physical and chemical properties. They having a different physical and chemical properties. Such type of compounds are called as isomers. Such type of compounds are called as isomers, and the phenomenon is known as isomerism. The phenomenon is known as isomerism. Based on the bonding connectivity, isomerism is two types. If they having same bonding connectivity, the bonding connectivity is same, such type of isomerism is known as stereoisomerism. If the bonding connectivity is different, such type of isomerism is known as structural isomerism. Again, the structural isomerism is six types: chain isomerism, positional isomerism, functional group isomerism or functional isomerism, metamerism, tautomerism, and ring chain isomerism. Ring chain isomerism. Okay, students. Now come to the stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism means based on the bonding connectivity. See, different different groups, arrangement of the groups around the carbon and carbon atoms. That is stereoisomerism is two types. One is conformational isomerism. The second one is configurational isomerism. Conformational isomerism and configurational isomerism. Conformational isomerism is mainly shown by the alkanes and cycloalkanes. Okay, now configurational isomerism again two types: geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism is mainly shown by the alkenes, carbon and carbon double bond containing compounds, to shows geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism. So the geometrical isomers are three types of geometrical isomers are present. That is cis and trans geometrical isomers, or syn and ze. E, syn and anti. Syn means same, anti means opposite. Another one is E and Z. Like three types of geometrical isomers are present. Next, optical isomerism. Optical isomerism means the organic compounds, the carbon atom. In organic compounds, the carbon atom is attached to four different groups are present. The type of compounds to exhibit optical isomerism. So the optical isomers are two types: enantiomers. The second one is diastereomers. What are enantiomers and diastereomers, and examples and everything we'll discuss stepwise. So first we'll discuss about the structural isomerism. Okay, students, anybody have doubt? Let inform to me. Abhay, Rani, Afzal, yes, ma, Varun, Nishal, yes, ma. Okay, very good, very good. Okay, listen now, very important, ma. This understanding of flow chart is one condition. The second one is what is structural isomerism, and what are the types of structural isomerism, and how to remember the examples, and what are the definition, and what are the important examples. That is very important. Just observation, clean observation important, then it becomes very easy. Okay, it's not that much difficulty. Okay, students, now let's see, we'll discuss about structural isomerism. Okay, structural isomerism. What is structural isomerism, dear students? Structural isomerism definition is nothing but the organic compounds having same molecular formula.
having same molecular formula. Molecular formula is same, but different bonding connectivity of carbon atoms. Different bonding connectivity or different structural arrangements. Structural arrangements different structural arrangements are different bonding connectivities present in that organic compounds. Those are called structural isomers. Those are called structural isomers, and the phenomenon is known as structural isomerism. Next, the structural isomerism is six types. I said there in the first type is chain isomerism. Chain isomerism. What is the meaning for chain isomerism? Means the compounds having same molecular formula. Molecular formula is same, but different arrangements of carbon atoms. Different arrangement of carbon chain. Different arrangements of carbon chain or parent chain. Or root word. See, here the organic compounds having same molecular formula but different root words are present. For example, the root word means longest carbon chain. In that one compound having longest carbon chain is a 3 carbons, another compound has 4 carbons, another compound has 5 carbons. Like different carbon chains or different parent chain is present. Those such type of compounds are called chain isomers. Chain isomers, and the phenomenon is known as chain isomerism. Okay, let's see, in order to show chain isomerism, how many minimum number of carbon atoms are required? 4 carbon atoms are required to show in order to show chain isomerism, minimum number of required carbon atoms equal to 4. 4 carbon atoms are required. Okay, mainly the chain isomerism is shown by alkanes. Examples: four carbon atoms means C4H10.
Molecular formula is C4H10. Four carbon atoms containing alkanes. Alkanes to show China isomerism. Minimum how many carbon atoms are required, dear students? Minimum four carbon atoms are required. Four carbon atoms containing alkane molecular formula is C4H10. So it has two China isomers. It has two China isomers. What are those? This is N-butane. Already common names of alkanes, I said alkanes. The carbon atoms all are in a straight chain, those are called as N-alkanes. So the four carbon atoms are present on the root wall, hence it is N-butane. Now out of the four carbon atoms on root wall, three carbon atoms you have to take from the root wall. It has one carbon chain. One carbon and carbon connectivity is changed. Then, what is this name, dear students? Two CH3 groups on end. This is also we can write like this. Like this. What it meaning? It is a name is isobutane. Isobutane. Now here the root word is three carbon atoms. What is the definition I said, dear students? Same molecular formula but different arrangements of carbon atoms. Different arrangement of carbon chain or parent chain. This carbon chain has four carbon atoms are present. Here the carbon chain, parent chain has three carbon atoms are present. Now one carbon substituent is present. Means just carbon atoms position only. The connectivity of carbon atoms are changed. Then on the root word or parent chain, carbon atoms connectivity is changed. The type of isomers are called as China isomers. These China isomers are also called as skeleton isomers. Skeleton isomers are nuclear isomers. It is also called as a skeleton isomers or nuclear isomers. So N-butane and isobutane are the two China isomers are present for four carbon atoms containing alkane. The same way five carbon atoms containing alkane. Let's see. Five carbon atoms containing alkane. Second example, C5H10 has three China isomers. What are those three China isomers? Let's listen, dear students. Five carbon atoms are in a straight chain. Four carbon atoms are in a straight chain. And three carbon atoms in a straight chain. And remaining substituents. Like how many arrangements we can draw that? Five carbons containing alkane, total three. That's why C5H10 has how many China isomers? Three China isomers are present. CH3 bond CH2, bond CH2, bond CH2, bond CH3. This name is M-pentane. Or IUPAC nomenclature you want means pent plus ANE, pentane. Now here, just on that parent chain, one carbon link you have to disconnect. There you have to write above, means it becomes a substituent. And the remaining four carbon atoms you have to arrange in the straight chain. Its name is isopentane. Again, one more carbon atom you have to disconnect from the parent chain. Here the root word is, our parent chain is five carbons, here root word is four carbon atoms. Only carbon and carbon connectivity is different, different carbon-carbon connectivity is different. different carbon and carbon connectivity present in parent chain or carbon chain or on root word. Such type of isomers are called as chain isomers. One more carbon connectivity you have, one more carbon you have to disconnect, then you have to write and you will get this type of structure. See, this carbon is there. Quaternary carbon is connected with four groups. That's why it is called quaternary carbon present in a alkane. Those compounds common name is called neoalkanes. I said like I shared that screenshot also. This name is neopentane. So total how many arrangements are present, dear students? Three only. That's why C5H10 has three chain isomers are present. So what are those three chain isomers? N-pentane, isopentane, neopentane. The same way six carbon atoms containing alkane is present, we can write five chain isomers. Six for five chain isomers, seven carbon atoms are present, then we'll get seven carbon atoms are present on the root word, or seven carbon atoms containing alkane is present, then we'll get nine chain isomers. Eight carbon atoms are present, eight carbon atoms containing alkanes are present, then we'll get 18 chain isomers. 9 present, 35. 10 present, we'll get 75 chain isomers are present. Okay, so like, but minimum you have to remember the examples, 4 carbon atoms and 5 carbon atoms enough. But remaining in objective exam, they will ask that I will give you that number of chain isomers in tabular form. Root words for neopentane, how many, mister? This is the straight chain. You have to take the straight chain up and down. Three, anywhere three carbon atoms are present. So the root word is three carbons. Now it's IUPAC nomenclature. Do you want to means 2,2-dimethylpropane? 2,2-dimethylpropane. Okay. Anybody have doubt? Remaining examples I will give you now. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Very good. Let's see. I will draw the remaining structures of 5 carbons over there, 6 carbons, C6, HN, C6H14 contains how many chain isomers are present? So it has 5 chain isomers are present. See, I will draw that 5 chain isomers in bond line structures. Bond line representation I will draw that. So that calculation we have to remember directly. Up to 10 carbon atoms enough. More than 10 carbon atoms they never ask. So that there is no any specified formula. But just it is imagination only. According that we have to draw the different arrangements. That's why I will give you that minimum. In order to exhibit chain isomerism for alkanes, how many minimum carbon atoms are required? Any organic compound minimum, how many carbon atoms are required? Four carbon atoms are required. Four. Okay. Now, four carbon atoms are present means how many chain isomers? Two chain isomers. Five carbon atoms are present, how many chain isomers? Three chain isomers are present. Six carbon atoms are present, how many chain isomers? Five chain isomers. Let's see what are those five chain isomers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The root word is 6 carbons. Means 6 carbon atoms are in the straight chain. Its name is N-hexane. Now, another 5 carbon atoms you have taken root word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The root word is 5 carbon atoms. Just you have to take the position like at these two methyl groups are at one end, then its name is isohexane. Now this methyl group position you have to write in middle, then we'll get 2-methylhexane. 2-methylpentane we'll get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Here if you have written that methyl group means 2 methyl pentane. Now here you written means 1 2 3 1 2 3, then it is secondary alkane or 3 methyl pentane. The root word is 5 carbons. Okay students, now root word 5 carbon atoms, like we are attaching different structures. How many? Two. One is 2 methyl pentane, another one is 3 methyl pentane. The 2 methyl pentane is also called as isohexane. Another 3 over 5 structures we need. Another structure, let's see. Four carbon atoms you have to take in a straight chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 2 methyl substance you have to take. The root word is 4 carbons. Now its IUPAC nomenclature is 2,3-dimethylbutane. Next, fifth one is the fifth one you have to write like this. Like neocarbon, that one carbon, so three group, four groups are present. The root word is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Root word is 4 carbons. Okay, then we get this name is neohexane. Neohexane are 2,2-dimethyl. Like how many China isomers are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 China isomers are present for C6H14. So these structures only you have to remember. 4 carbons in mainly in examination JEE and NEET or whatever it may be. Competition exam, what type of questions may be, they will ask me 4 carbons containing China isomer structures and their formulas. And 5 carbons and 6 carbons, if at least they want to ask, means maximum 6 carbons they will ask. Some rare case, but mainly 4 and 5 only they will ask. Okay. So that these are the different China isomers. I will give you one tabular form directly. Let's see the tabular form. Number of carbon atoms. In alkane,